Happy Monday, y'all. We are over here at the in-laws' house by the pool. Katie's getting the workout written down on the whiteboard over there.
Chalkboard.
Sorry. Gonna be a fun one.
Got the setup. Got the dog washing. Katie getting it ready.
All right, y'all, workout of the day is gonna be a 15 minute AMRAP. AMRAP goes for as many reps or as many rounds as possible. This one's gonna be 20 single arm dumbbell snatches. Then we're gonna go to 40 double unders, 20 burpees, and then 40 more double unders. We're gonna be going through that as many times as we can in 15 minutes, trying to get around 5+ rounds, okay? So pick a weight on your dumbbell that'll allow you to do those snatches unbroken. Should be a moderate, maybe a little bit heavier weight. Double unders, really you wanna pick a variation that'll allow you to do it in probably about 45 seconds to a minute. So if you cannot do double unders, we're gonna go to singles. So 60 singles. We're just gonna go to 1.5 times as many singles. 20 burpees, we'll go over that movement. Everybody should know what that is. Then before that, we're gonna do the warm up. It's gonna be 2 rounds of 30 just regular old single unders, 1 minute of active Spider-Mans. Probably see the squirrel. Get each other. Go. Then 15 air squats and then 10 dumbbell strict press. So just from the shoulder to overhead, no bend underneath it. All right, y'all, the warm up is gonna start off with 2 rounds of 30 singles and then 1 minute of active Spider-Man. What an active Spider-Man is gonna look like. Katie's gonna demonstrate over here for us. Move this way out of the way. Can you demonstrate an active Spider-Man here for me, Katie? One lead leg forward, back leg should stay straight. You wanna kinda kick that lead knee out as you're sitting into it, kinda pushing those hips down. You're gonna hold it for maybe 4 or 5 seconds and then you're going to switch legs. So going back and forth here. Good stretch, good stretch. All right, then you're gonna stand up. We're gonna do air squats, 15 of them. So feet about shoulder width apart, toes pointed slightly out. You wanna go to a full depth squat, so that means the hip crease below that knee, and then stand it all the way back up. Great job. Then 10 dumbbell strict press. Katie, you wanna grab this 70 here for us? Guys, with the heavier weight, if you only have one dumbbell, you could start off with a dual strict press where you're holding each end of the hex, pressing up overhead. So maybe the first round, do it this way, 10 of them, and then you can go to a single arm. So switch over to one arm and press it up overhead like that on the second round. That way, if you have a lighter dumbbell, you can start off with a lighter dumbbell and then switch to a little bit heavier dumbbell or the weight you plan on using in the workout. We can warm up the shoulders. Guess who's back again?
How's warm up, Katie?
It was good.
Yeah?
Strict press is a little hefty with that 25 pounds, so I did the horizontal way. So it was all good.
Anything else?
No.
All right, guys.
Gotta get that slimming view. You gotta really slim up this neck.
All right, guys. Workout of the day has single arm dumbbell snatches in it. The dumbbell snatch. Focus point is actually going to be keeping that elbow extended until we get those hips opened up completely. So we want to use those bigger muscles in our legs before we start pulling with that upper body and our shoulder. So we're going to do a little progression to get towards that. Once you guys are doing this at home, make sure those shins stay fairly vertical. You're going to deadlift it up. So that's where you're using all the power in your legs and kind of getting that hinging motion here. Once you get your hips opened up, your elbow should still stay extended. The next pull will actually bring your elbow up and bringing that dumbbell up to eye level, okay? Then the next one is going to be the punch and the drop back underneath. So the progression is going to be, we're gonna do some deadlifts. I wanna go 4 deadlifts here, just opening up those hips, and then we'll do a hips open, pull up, making sure those hips open before you start bending that elbow, and then the punch back at the top. So hips open, pull up to your head, drop back underneath, punching those elbows out at the end. Okay? Then you can alternate in the air here between each one, or you can alternate on the ground, switching hands there. That is the single arm dumbbell snatch.
All right, guys, the next movement on the workout is going to be double unders. Double unders is when the jump rope goes underneath your feet twice through each jump. So the focus point of today is actually going to be the placement of those hands. So really you want to keep those hands in and you want to keep those elbows back whenever you're going through those double unders. You don't want to just think elbows in, because actually you could still bring those hands out. And what that does is actually shortens the rope. If you notice here, the first kind of instinct people do whenever they start going on their double unders is to start going out with the rope. And when they go out with the rope, that rope shortens, and that's what causes a lot of people to trip. So keeping those elbows in and back through your double unders. Try it at home if you've never done it before. It's a fun one. A little frustrating sometimes. Some people just pick it up, like Katie.
No.
Me, takes forever.
Three whips. Give yourself three whips and then move on. It's worth it.
Remember, guys, if you can't do double unders, or you just don't feel like getting whipped by the jump rope, we're gonna do 60 single unders, which is just jump rope going underneath you one time. Next movement is going to be, Katie, you got a phone call.
I got it.
Next movement is going to be the burpee. So what that's gonna look like is your chest and your legs going all the way to the ground. Then what you're going to do is try to bring your feet all the way back up to your hands. So you notice you brought them all the way forward and then out. That actually makes it a little bit easier when you're cycling through those burpees. Hands up over your head, a little hop up to the top. Guys, what I want you to do is to keep moving on this movement. So if you need to do a step back onto it, you can. Just one big step back and one big step forward. Hands back overhead, little daylight underneath your feet. I would rather you do that, so you can keep moving in the workout, than trying to do the other one super, super fast and then not be able to get through it. 20 burpees is quite a bit. Then we'll go back to 40 double unders or 60 single unders. Jump rope. Great job, Katie.
Thanks.
Great job, Charlie.
She was like,
let's get it started. Thanks for tuning in, guys. That was a good one. The water was a lot colder than we expected.
Freaking freezing.
I was out of breath when the workout ended, and I hopped in the pool, and quickly any breath I had left escaped my body. So I was a little afraid of drowning, but we got back up.
It's still cold.
It was a good one, guys. A pretty shoulder-dominant workout for sure. So get ready for some bolder shoulders after this workout for sure. See it? It's already getting pumped right here. You see it? Yeah. Uh-huh. You like it, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
She likes it. Well, guys, day 12 done, I think.
Right.
Day 12. Happy Monday.
Yeah.
Keep crushing it, guys. Keep killing it. If you find you a pool, hop in one. It's finally getting to a decent temperature.
The water's still freezing.
It's a little cold. It's okay. It's all right. We're suffering through it. It's good after a workout. You don't care about the cold as much. But
it's like an ice bath. Recovery.
Yeah, recovery. Recovery. Well, anything you need to say, Katie, before we head out?
It's harder than I thought it was going to be, but...
Oh, it wasn't that bad. Just
do it. I thought it was, but you'll be fine. Chris had to encourage me a few times, so do this one with a partner if you can.
Oh, yeah. And I think the score, me and Katie, it's 1-1. I got this one.
He
might have won that reverse burpee one, but I got
it to him.
I got... We'll go back and check who had who and who gave it
to
who.
He definitely had me.
Definitely.
And he even had a 70-pound dumbbell.
Definitely
so
won.
I'll give him this one.
All right, guys. Keep killing it. Crushing it.
Yes.
We love y'all.
Stay encouraged. Don't give up.
Bye.
Bye.